I'm going to show you how to export 4K videos in Premiere Pro 2025 in very high quality for YouTube, Facebook, Vimeo, your clients, etc. And to save you time, I've actually created a set of free export presets that you can download at the link in the video description, which will save you a ton of time and give you all of these high quality 4K export settings immediately without you needing to dial in all of the settings manually. They even come with instructions showing you how to import them into Premiere Pro, so go download them for free below. Moving on, open up Premiere Pro, and as you can see, I've already created a project here with a 4K 24 frames per second video on the timeline. And let's pretend that this video is now fully done and it's ready to be exported. Once you reach this point, you can either press Control M on PC or Command M on Mac, or you can go up here to the Export tab and click on that. Regardless, whatever you do, it's gonna open up this Export Media dialog box. And with the export settings open, make sure that Media File over here on the left is selected. And then here, you can choose a name for your video. In this case, let's call it Allison and Mark Wedding Film. Cool, we'll do that. You can title your video whatever you want. Just leave that .mp4 at the end there. And then you're gonna want to click on location here. And this is very important because this is where you're going to save your video file. I usually like to make a video folder called renders, and then I will put the exported video in there and click save. And if you remember one thing from this, please remember where you saved your video file. Otherwise you're gonna be very confused and you're gonna be like, where's my video? It is where you saved it in this folder. Next, for preset, you're gonna wanna click this drop-down menu and go down to high quality 2160p 4K and select that. And at this point, you're probably thinking, this is great, Matt. Do I just go down here and hit export and I'm good to go, right? No, because remember, I told you at the start of this video, I want to give you the best possible export settings. And by default, Adobe's not quite going to give you the best. So this means we need to dig into this video settings tab here, which there's some settings, and spoiler, you click more, there's a lot more settings, but do not worry. Hold on to your beard. Things are gonna get complicated, but I'm gonna walk you through it all and make it easy. Starting off, for frame size, you want UHD 3840 by 2160, frame rate 23.976. If it's grayed out, you can click this little checkbox over here to be able to change your setting if you need to. And for field order progressive and aspect ratio, leave that at square pixels 1.0. Next, make sure that the render at maximum depth and use maximum render quality boxes are checked because we want the highest quality of video, right? Yeah, you definitely want that, so leave those checked. Scroll down now, and under encoding settings, for performance, make sure that hardware encoding is selected if it is available. If it isn't available and you only see software, that's okay, but hardware encoding will enable your computer to render your videos dramatically faster because Premiere is going to use your computer's graphics card, so I highly recommend having hardware encoding selected if available. Next, for profile, leave that set to high, and for level, you're going to want to select 5.2 if that isn't available. Side note, by the way, I want you to notice here that there is also a high 10 setting. You may be thinking, well, if we're already high, why don't we go to high 10, right? Go really fancy. You do not want to do that, okay? You're only gonna do that if you are exporting an HDR video using an entire HDR editing workflow, which is outside the scope of this video. So just leave it on high. Trust me, I've had people tell me, oh, I chose high 10 and the video looks weird. Yeah, because you don't wanna do that. So leave it set to high. For HDR graphics white nits, leave that set to 203, which should be the default. And lastly, we gotta go down here to bitrate settings. And this is where things get super important because this is the biggest setting that's going to affect the quality of your video that you're exporting. If you want the highest possible video quality, for bitrate encoding, you're going to want to select CBR, which stands for constant bitrate, which basically means that Premiere is always going to be telling your video to be as high quality as possible. And for your target bitrate, you're going to want to crank this up to 100 megabits per second. That's what that MBPS stands for. This is going to result in a very big file here. And as you can see under this estimated file size section in the bottom right, it says that this video, which is a minute and 27 seconds long, is already 1 gig in size. So it's a beefy video file, but this large file size is completely worth it if you want the highest quality 4K video whenever you upload to YouTube. Incidentally, speaking of the highest quality videos on YouTube, even if you did not film your video in 4K and you filmed it in 1080p, for example, I would still recommend using these 4K export settings for basically everything that you export if you're uploading your video to YouTube. Because if you upscale your lower resolution video files to 4K and then export them and upload them to YouTube in 4K, YouTube is going to use a significantly higher bitrate whenever it's playing your video back, and the quality will be dramatically better than if you had uploaded it in HD. So a hack to make sure you have the highest quality. So in short, always upload to YouTube in 4K, and you can do that for pretty much any other site, either Facebook or Vimeo, etc. It will pretty much always help you if you upload your video in 4K. With all that done, let's go down here to the audio tab, and all of these should be good by default. Audio format AAC, 48,000 hertz, stereo, 320 kilobits per second bitrate. Like I said, these should all be already set up, but it doesn't hurt to check. And with that, congratulations. Your video settings are all done, and you're about ready to export your video. But if you want to save time and avoid having to go back and dial in all of these settings every single time that you export a video in the future, you now have two options. First, you can download my free presets that'll give you all of these settings that we've covered and enable you to use them as a preset every single time you export your video in one click. Pretty awesome, right? They're available for free. You can download the link down below, or you can actually create your own preset by saving all the settings that we just put together as a preset of your own. And to do that, all you have to do is go up here to the preset section, go to these three dots to the right, click save preset, and then it's gonna ask you to choose a name. So let's call this H.264 4K 24 FPS 100 Mbps, which are all the critical settings. And we'll throw in Who Is Matt there at the end, so you remember who helped you make it. Press OK, and then anytime that you want to export your videos using these settings, all you have to do is click this preset drop down, and right down here is going to be your preset. So you just click on that, and that's going to give you all of these settings instantly, saving you a lot of time. After that, to export your video, all you have to do is go over here and click Send to Media Encoder to export using Adobe Media Encoder, or hit Export, and your video's done. That's it. Thank you so much for watching this video all about to export high-quality 4K videos in Adobe Premiere Pro, and because I would love to help you out even more, I've put together a free guide called Edit Videos Like a Pro. This guide is going to walk you through some of my biggest tips that I have for you as a video editor, and these things took me years to learn, and you can use this guide to take a huge shortcut. So download the Edit Videos Like a Pro guide completely for free at the link in the video description. Thanks so much for watching, and have a great day.